I would like to speak about acne today. Acne is a condition that can affect us in many stages of our life. It is estimated about 70% of all people will have had acne at some point of time or in some form during their lifetime. It is most prominent in our teenage years and perhaps young adulthood. However, it can start as early as the end of our childhood years at an age of 9, 10, 11, or it may even persist or even start at the age of 40, 50, sometimes even later than that, however that is rare. Acne can take many different expressions. When we are younger, it's typically located a little higher on our face, and as we get older, and if acne occurs, it typically occurs on the lower portion of the face. And sometimes even the neckline. Acne occurs because of a number of different conditions that play together. There's a genetic inability to properly shed off the skin around the hair follicles. The hair follicles also serve as the outlets of our oil glands. When oil gets trapped in the oil glands and cannot actually properly be excreted onto the skin, it enlarges the oil gland itself. That causes an inflammatory response in the surrounding skin, which brings in white blood cells that try to fight that pressure from the oil glands. Also, the filled oil gland will serve as a reservoir for bacteria that normally live on our skin but can actually then feed on the oil inside the oil glands. All of that together can as well cause additional inflammation when bacteria are present within oil glands. So there can be multiple different expressions, as I already alerted to. There is mild, there's moderate, there's severe or sometimes cystic acne. And there can be acne that's located not only on the face, back or chest, which are the common locations, but there can sometimes be atypical variants of acne where acne is located on the scalp, sometimes even other areas of the body. So there are different treatments. Suggestions according to the different presentations of acne, and they are oftentimes aimed at reducing the salient feature of the acne. There's treatment for mild acne, there's treatment for moderate acne, there's treatment for severe or cystic acne, and I will be introducing those type of treatments in a future segment.